Hi, this is Leonard Smith from Sense Memory, and I've been tagged, so stay tuned and find out exactly what the tag is all about. So I'm in the middle of moving or packing up to move in the next couple of weeks, and so I'm in this almost empty room, and there's probably a big echo. Anyway, I've been tagged by Chad from Shaven on the Dark Side, and this tag is called About My Fragrance Journey. And so I want to thank Chad for tagging me and getting me off my butt to do another video in the middle of this move. So we have some content coming, and that's good. There are 11 questions, and let's start with the first one. The first one is, how many bottles do you own? I own roughly about between 165 and 175 bottles right now, and it goes up and down between, it's been as low in the last year at about 130, but I went shopping in San Francisco and been buying things, so it's gone back up. Question number two, how do you store your fragrances? I'm really bad about that. I keep them all out. They're not in direct sunlight, but there's sunlight coming into the room. I just really like to have all my bottles right there handy. But the room is controlled temperature-wise. It's always about 68 degrees in this house. So it's cool, but not dark. But when I get into my new place, I'm going to be investing in some really good storage facilities, perhaps some beverage refrigerator kind of things, you know, that you have for like wine and whatnot. Question number three, what was your first fragrance? My first fragrance was either English leather or British Sterling. It was a Christmas present from my parents when I was a teenager. The first fragrance I bought was Chanel Pour Monsieur. That was when I was in college. And I've told that story before, but basically, in those days, it was a small period of time when Chanel actually sold fragrances in drugstores. And I walked into a drugstore in Berkeley, California, when I was visiting from the school I went to. I was visiting friends at Berkeley. Walked into a little drugstore, and there was Chanel Pour Monsieur, and I bet it's $25, which in 1971 was a lot of money, especially for a kid in college. So I had to make a decision on whether I was going to eat or whether I was going to smell good, and I decided to smell good. Question number four is, what is your newest fragrance? My newest fragrance is thanks to Dan, known as Mr. Smelly, and that would be Capucci. He reviewed this just this last week, and it sounded so wonderful. I have to say, it is really, really great. I'm very, very happy to have this. I will be doing a review of it. Oh boy, it smells so wonderful. Just really great. So I'm going to be doing a review on that. And let's see, question number five, what is the most expensive fragrance? And that would be probably, I bought a little quarter ounce or half ounce bottle of Shalimar, and that was a nearly $400. That was about $375 for that little bottle, and it was worth it. It was really worth it. I love that beautiful fragrance. Number six, what is your best bargain fragrance? Oh God, I don't know. That's a toughie. It might be this right now. This is really wonderful Capucci. I think I paid $21 for this, and yeah. So let's just say right now, it changes, but right now it's Capucci. So there you go. Capucci's pretty great. And let's see. Question number seven, what is your favorite fragrance store? That is another hard question. I really love, when I lived in San Francisco, my three favorite fragrance stores were, for me to go to, were Tiger Lily, which is all independent fragrances, wonderful on Valencia Street. I loved going to Barney's New York. I had great friends there who were wonderful. I really enjoyed going to Neiman Marcus. My good friend Miha works there. The Nose of Union Square. And I also loved going to the Chanel boutique. They were so wonderful there. So I can't pick a favorite. I just can't. It was just my routine to go to all of them. When I went fragrance shopping, I'd hit them all and loved them all. And just if you're in San Francisco, you've got to try all of those. They're just great. Okay, question number eight. What's your favorite fragrance in your collection? That is so tough. That is so tough. Probably right now, I would say Roaring Radcliffe by Penhaligon's. It is amazing. It is just amazing. I have to do a review on that. I got that when I was in San Francisco. So right now, at this moment, Roaring Radcliffe takes that the honors. What is your what number nine? What is your next fragrance to purchase? I really don't know. I'm in the middle of this move, so I haven't really thought about purchasing anything new for a while. But once I get moved, I'm going to go up to Seattle and go fragrance shopping and get something wonderful. Let's see. Number 10, what is your dream fragrance to purchase? My dream fragrance to purchase? Probably a Rose d'Auvergne. I mean, when I was in New York a year ago, went to Bertolf Goodman on Fifth Avenue, met a wonderful sales associate there, Thomas Crutchfield, who is in charge of the or is the rep for Rose d'Auvergne. And I smelled this incredible fragrance that was made specifically by Rose d'Auvergne for Bertolf Goodman's, and it was I think it was called For Him or Just Him. I may be mistaken, but anyway, if you're ever in New York, go to Bertolf Goodman's and have lunch. Have lunch on the restaurant at the top. It's just wonderful, and with a great view of Central Park. And then visit Thomas and smell all of the Rose d'Auvergne. So probably Rose d'Auvergne would be really, really wonderful. I can't stop smelling this. It's so good. And finally, number 11. Oh, who would like to see do this fragrance tag? Oh, golly. I think probably I would like to see, if he hasn't done it already, let me think. I had to think for a minute. So I think I would choose the Sentinel, and I would also choose Jeremy from Jeremy Fragrance. It'd be interesting to see what those two guys have to say. So this is Leonard Smith saying, remember, wear what you love and not what they say you should like, and I'll be talking to you soon. Bye-bye.